Good morning, everyone. Again, welcome to the opportunity of listening to some of the nice talk. Colonel Gehlot, he is head of department in Chandigarh Hospital. He will be taking today's lecture, the tumors of salivary gland.
Good morning, everyone. I am grateful to Sanjay sir, and whatever I am today, I am because of we generally same TC sir, Tathagat Chatterjee sir, in short form. So basically, I will tell brief of the salivary gland. They are exocrine tubular acidic glands in nature. Basically, there are three types depending on the content there. Serous glands that contain amylase, mainly the parotid glands are there. Mucinous glands, that is the silomucin secretes silomucin, and sublingual is the category. Mixed ones, which are both the shallow and the serous, they are subendocrine glands. Depending on the architecture, their glands are two types, two things, luminal inner layer and outer abluminal layer. These two glands and layers are important because we have to know the origin of the salivary tumors, whether they are dual in nature, whether they are belonging to mapillary cell layer or luminal layer or abluminal layer. So this is the diagram. It is given in the Fletcher volume edition 2, old edition. This is a beautiful diagram and I learned it during my PG days. So what you are seeing, initially part is the acinus. Acinus cells inside the luminal cells are there, and they are the myoepithelial cells on the acinus part. So see, this location is important once you give the things for the original cell, then from the integrated duct, and then selected them as you get. So here the myoepithelial part is slowly taken over by the basal cell. So these two components are there. Inner layer is the luminal and outer layer is the abluminal, that is comprising of myoepithelial basal cells. So these are generally marker we will come across later on. So basically, normal salivary gland, it contains mapillary cell, basal cell marker. The beauty of the mapillary cell is it has both the markers truly expressed for the smooth muscle tail tumor markers like calponin, desmin, and MSA, as well as caldesmon. In addition, it has the expression for the epithelial cell. So they are pointing for the P63 and PAN-CK also. In addition, it has the unusual expression of the GFAP positivity and assembly. So whenever you are planning to see any mapillary cell or basal cell, like in the, you have to see in the basal cell, you see in the prostate carcinoma, basal, the breast carcinoma, you have to see whether they breach or not. So you can do any marker of those. So basically, it's the first slide, it is showing calponin expression of mapillary cells, and P60 has nucleus both the mapillary cells and the basal cells. So salivary gland tumors broadly classified as the benign neoplasm and the malignant neoplasm. They are diverse and uncommon. They comprise 3% of all neoplasm head and neck. Benign tumors are more, they are around 64.3%, and malignant ones comprise of 36.8%. Most common site is the parotid glands, as you are aware, and it constitutes around 65-80% of the cells. Benign tumors generally develop in the later age, 5 to 6 decades. Most of the parotid tumors, they are female predominant, except one. This is the WHO classification. Benign tumors, phylloadenoma, you are aware very well. Myoepithelioma, basal cell adenoma, Bardens, oncocytoma, canaligula, sebaceous, duct and cyst adenoma. Malignant ones, acinic cell, mucoepidermoid, adenocystic, PLGA, and so on. Other entities, broadly entities are non-neoplastic epithelial tumors, benign soft tissue lesions and hematolymphoid lesions. So here comes the role of origin of the cells. There are two theories are there, bicellular theory and multicellular theory. Bicellular theory, two types of cells, integrated ducts, tumor like phylloadenoma adenoma, Bardens tumors, oncocytoma, acinic cell, adenocystic, they arise from the integrated duct. And you can see integrated duct, they are the connecting link between the acinus and the stated duct part. So if you are seeing this interconnected duct, so these are the tumor driving up, phylloadenoma, Bardens, oncocytoma, acinic cell. Once you have this diagram in mind, you can understand from where the tumor is arising and what is the likely nature of the IST. It is going to help you remember running all the panels. Acinic duct generally tumor the squamous cells and mucoepidermoid. Multicellular is again one more theory there, multicellular theory. It says stated duct are the origin for the oncocyte tumor, acinic cells or acinic cell carcinoma, SP3 are eligible, squamous mucoepidermoid, integrated duct and what they give the phylloadenoma. So this is phylloadenoma, they are bimodal in nature. and it has improved again also because there was for the quality for the growth of the epithelial cells as well as the map of the component both are there in the proliferative neuroma. So depending on the first anything you see in the histopathology, diagnosis is made of the 2x, maximum at 4x. 10x you require in some if you want to further classify that any tumor or things. So basically, first of the things that you are aware in any tumor, whether it's Hodgkin's tumor or periphery tumor, any site, whether circumvascular or infiltrating. If you know the characteristic of broad at 2x or 4x, circumvascular, then you can make the video primary tumor, basal cell tumor, or Hodgkin's tumor. In your characteristics, the secondary part. If they are infiltrating nature, then you can see they are maybe adenocystic, epithelial mapping carcinoma, or basal cell adenocarcinoma. Pilomafic adenoma, it is most common of salivary gland tumor. 70% are parotid glands, 60% are the seminal glands, and 45 manosphagic glands, 6% sublingual tumor. 4 to 6 decades are common in presentation. However, I just reported one case around 13-year-old son of serving officer, pilomafic adenomas, last 2 months later. So, as you know, they are more in the female, 3:4:1. They are pure epithelial divergent differentiation. Divergent differentiation means whenever you see the settlement morphology, then you see the OC differences, contrary differences, visual differences. So this is the bit divergent name. They are slow growing, being benign, paleness masses. In the parotid, 90% is superficial lobe, most in the part of tail. Manosphagic glands included are lateral palate and submucosal mass. They can be solitary versus synchronous. What are synchronous means? Synchronous means when any two tumor you are diagnosing in a patient within 6 months, either or simultaneously. If the between the two tumors, dual tumors is there, any patient more than 6 months of the gap, they are called a metachronous. You are gross, you have seen mostly. They are smooth, well demarcated, solid. 60 changes are there along with the submixoid stroma. Histology, you know very well, I'm not going to tell. So this is the characteristic feature of any, if you see both the components are there, this is the stroma component, this is the epithelial component. And the characteristic part is the mixed stroma. Once you see mixed stroma in the epithelial, you see such a beautiful magenta color of the mixed stroma. So you, any head and neck swelling with mixed stroma, you go for the primary stroma. But other thing is, you should take in mind, primary stroma, these components, both macular component and the both the brain components are. So there can be the mesial component may be the at various differentiation may be there. Now monomorphic adenoma. Monomorphic adenoma, I use the term because pilomic adenoma components has both the features, epithelial and myepithelial. These monomorphic adenoma, they are basal cell and like canalicular, sebaceous, glabrous, clear cells adenomas, they have only one epithelial component in the nature origin. Basal cell is most common one, 1.81 benign epithelial cerebral tumor. They are commonly 6 decades, more or less equal, and most common site is parotid as usual. Basal cell adenoma has a different patterns. So if you see, this is a solid pattern. But if you see such morphology, where have you seen anywhere else? Can you say that if you have these two features, like you are saying, like peripheral palisading is there? And component in there. Suppose you don't have this, all the things is not there. You have this thing. So then you can see a 3D of the ameloblastoma in your mind. If the site is different, but just for the morphology part of the 2x part, if the thing. So what is the solid component? They are most common. Solid natural tumors you can see. For basaloid, BCC also comes to your mind. Because you can, but the BCC has other peripheral cracking also. So in general, if these features are there, you can see BCC in your mind and site is there. Uniform cells are there, they are hypochromatic, non-nucleate, with indistinct cytoplasm, peripheral level parasitic, I told you, it is a characteristic feature in the solid pattern of basal cell adenoma.
They are the typical pattern where the cells are arranged elongated with vascular stroma in between. Tubular pattern, like tubular adenoma on the breast, you have seen. So you have seen similar architecture. So what the beauty of the histopathology is, site may be anyone. But if you know the architecture, you come to the diagnosis. So here what we see multiple duct-like structures are there, columnar cells lining in the vascular stroma there. Suppose the breast tissue, so we label it as the tubular adenoma. This is the membranous component.
Here you are seeing characteristic thick mucinic membrane. They are surrounding the natural tumor cell. Or zigzag pattern appearance. So once you do the path stain, they come very beautifully quality for the path stains.
Other component of monomorphic canonical adenoma, uncommon, but among the commonest sites, the minor salivary gland, they generally see in the 7th to 7th decade, more in female. Canonical adenoma, they are well-selected site,
multiple foci is there, tubular structures are there, which are lined by the pubertal columnar cells, and stroma is vascular component is there.
Oncocytoma. Oncocytoma, as the name says, whether it is the thyroid, whether it is salivary gland, whether it is kidney, the feature is same, the cells are benign living cells, and in the salivary gland, they are common in 60 decades, male and female are common, equally projected, thyroid is the commonest site, followed by salivary glands, and some cases in the palate, buccal, mucosa, and tongue. So, oncocytoma present as the enlarging painless masses. Technetium, this is the stain, they show the mitochondrial hyperplasia, as you are very well aware.
So what I am seeing here, on the gross EBC specimen, they are the encapsulated, homogeneous, smooth, with orange luster, histopathology, cores of uniform cells are there, thin fiber stroma. Can you see this thin fiber lining is there, within the cells? Large polyhedral cells, distinct cell membrane is there, granular distribution cellular, due to the hypermetabolic metabolism. So this is the characteristic. Central round vascular nucleus is there. What is the other tumor you see like this in the head and neck?
Hurdle cell, one more. Granular cell tumor, you see the tongue, na? Similarly, in the morphology, just give the DD. So it should come to your mind. That also has similar pictures. Sir. In the head and neck, just whenever I see any slides. So when I do PG, what I used to see, I am just sharing my one experience. I never see the history. I may be wrong at that time. I have to see slide blankly. Tray comes in the morning. Then once I make a picture, then I see the history. So by that time, you know you are not biased. Suppose I say liver. So liver, you know that the lesions are there. So the mind is not open. You see the slides, try to do 2 sets and out of 10. Don't do all the things. Then you can really pick up.
So on the retinal microscope, what we see, it is a retinal microscopy, microhemorrhage is there, and it constitutes 60% of cell volume. It's just for aggregate, but not the routine things.
Bardeen's tumor, also on a papillary cyst adenoma lymphomatosis. One of the commonest right in the PG exam. Whether it is FNAC, whether it is biopsy. Generally, we see around 1 or 2 cases in 3 months in routine practice. But exam slide is there, definitely it is there. So 6 to 10% of peritoneal neoplasm, older adjacent males, 10% bilateral multicentric, 3% acid neoplasm, slow-growing painless mass. This is the only tumor where is male predominance is there. And history of smoking is there. So if you have a history of smoking and male is there in the salivary gland, you should give thought to the Bardeen's tumor. This is a gross. If you see the specimen, they are encapsulated, smooth with the lobulated surface. Cystic space variable sizes are there with viscous fluid and saggy epithelium. Solid area with white nodules present the lymphoid follicles. Once you see the slide in the life, you remember whole our life. These are the few slides in the histopath.
You can't forget, even you think. So this is one of them. Papillary projections are there, which are growing up into cystic spaces and surrounding by the lymphoid stroma. Epithelial cell, a double cell layer, as you have the liminal cells inside, out of the basal cells. Stroma is mature one, lymphoid follicle in general centers are there. And there are two PGMs. I have seen one case of Bardeen's tumor that has gone to the metastatic lymph node.
So, question is,
sir, sir, number one thing, they are very circumscribed, first of all. And we are seeing the mature germ cell general center is there.
In the Bartoma, there are diffuse seeds of the cells are there. So more and more population will be there in Bartoma. There will be mature cells, immature cells, the various maturation will be there. Secondly, you will see the projection, cystic papillary projection in the Bartoma. So you will see the line here between them. Maybe it's given any, maybe they are cutting any four with it.
Okay, I have four resident maybe. Any comment on the lymphoepithelial lesions?
Sir, lymphoepithelial lesions means they are generally common in the head and neck region. So where, what is the meaning of the word specifically? Where the lymphoid cells, malignant lymphoid cells, they are infiltrating the lining epithelium. So the lymphoepithelial region is, lymphoepithelium we say it. Generally we enter the head and neck area only. Oral cavity we see lymphoepithelium. So here you see, you can clearly say, this is the liminal layer, inner one, outside the basal layer, underside the follicles, lymphoid cells is there, this is the lymphoid. Similarly, see the lining, liminal layer, basal layer, lymphoid cell. So this is a characteristic feature of this.
Myoepithelioma. This is the tumor that has the only one cell of it, that is myoepithelial cells.
Then that is 1% of cervical gland. See the third of CT case, female again, they are more affected. Minor cervical is the predominant site for a parotid and some adrenal glands. They are alone being the benign nature, they present asymptomatic masses. So this streaming of the cells, when you see monotropic cells streaming without any pattern. So the things you should, whenever you see the cervical gland tumor, first of all you should see the architecture. Second thing you should see whether they are the potential epithelial nature or myoepithelial nature. One of the cells are epithelial nature, you have the different duties, like it can be microperitoneal, or it can be parotid or other things. If you are seeing monomorphic, bland or spindle to oval cells are there, the first thing come to your mind, you are seeing any myoepithelial cell origin tumor, where it can be myoepithelioma also. And depending on the ATPR, mitosis, necrosis, it can be the carcinoma also. And sometimes if myoepithelial component is very prominent, so then what you see, whether the epithelium has a carcinoma also, it can be there. So these three things should come to your mind on the CT. So myoepithelium being a benign lesion, spindle cells are there, they are more common, parotid common site, uniform cell, central nuclei, granular porphyry cytoplasm, transmitted cells, polygonal descent, they are very few in nature. But monomorphic spindle cell and in other cell, once you are seeing this, you should have duty of the mesenchymal lesion also in your mind. Whether I'm dealing with leiomyoma or some any other small cell tumor or things like that. So what you distinguish is, suppose you're seeing the small biopsies there and you're thinking myoepithelioma, so you should advise the ISC marker. So one is the thing you have to, myoepithelial marker like PAN-CK and P63 or S100 or calponin, whatever things. In addition, you have to want, if it is leiomyoma, it will be negative for PAN-CK. If it is myoepithelioma, it will positive for both. In addition, you can see Ki-67 for any soft tissue tumor. Myoepithelial cell also, the part of soft tissue tumor also. So you can do the case in all the cases. And in addition, sir, I will go just little for info also. So once we are seeing any smooth muscle or any, sorry, mesenchymal tumor like benign or malignant, so basically three things come to our mind despite this site of the cervical gland. So either it is a skeletal muscle, or it is a smooth muscle, or it is myoepithelial or myofibroblastic. Four things should come to your mind. If it is a smooth muscle, you can do MSA positive in all of them. Then you have to distinguish muscular origin there, then SMA, desmin positive, then they are the favoring the smooth muscle origin. If they are desmin and calponin, all the negative, then you do the RM, for the rhabdomyosarcoma, you can do myoglobinogenin also. And myoepithelial cells, you have the both expressions, but myofibroblastic epithelial origin tumors, they have the partial expression for the desmin, may or may not be positive, calponin, may or may not be positive, but caldesmin is the definitive stain, but we generally don't perform it. So that is by the definition of exclusion, because everywhere in the government setup, we don't have the caldesmin as is so commonly used. Mucoepithelial carcinoma, this is also commonest, one of the most common cervical tumor. They are comprises 5 to 9%. Parotid is again mostly affected site. Parotid is the other side. 3 to 8 decades are seen. Peak in the 5th decade. Females are more commonly seen. Cadences are more than African females. They can be, there is Bradman classification is there for the, to decide the grading of the mucoepithelial carcinoma. So that different parameters are there. So like you have to see whether the infective pattern is there, whether nerve invasion is there, whether bone invasion is there, whether necrosis is there, what is the rate of mitosis is there. So depending on the parameter, they have to do the numbering of the cell. If the number is level 4, it is benign, low grade. 4 to 8 is the intermediate grade, more than 8 is the high grade. So, and other part of the things to decide other than this criteria, whether what is solid component is more or cystic component is more. So, low grade, they are slow growing, painless masses. High grade, they are rapidly growing. Minor cervical gland may be mixed in benign or hematopoietic process like hemangioma, papilloma, or tori. Gross pathology, bare circumcised to partially encapsulated to encapsulated. Solid tumor may be cystic in patient. Cystic is just because of the high rapidly necrotizing masses, lesions are there along with the cystic cells.
In the breeding, any cutoff of the percentage of the solid part is the cystic.
Sir, basically, this proportion of the things we have, and basically we have to see in the microscopy, sir, what is the proportion of the cystic and solid component in there?
More the solid, higher the grade.
Sir, histology, sir, low grade, mucous cells are more than epidermal cells, primary cystic are the low grade, and mature cellular elements are there. So if you see carefully, these are the mucinous cells, you see, low grade egg cells are there, these are the intermediate cells are there, and epithelial cells are there. Mucous cells and epithelial cells. So, what's the origin of the cells? Intermediate cell for the mucopolytic carcinoma. Intermediate grade, they have the mucous epithelium, both the components same. Fewer as smaller cysts are there. In the plane of the magnetic figure is there, characteristic of the intermediate grade.
So, these classifications are very, it is subjective. So, they have made it objective by getting the criteria for the parameters you have to look for before giving out any mucopolytic carcinoma report.
In the high grade, more solid component is there and they can be distinguished for the squamous cell carcinoma, but you do machine staining. Always the mucopolytic carcinoma being the, because there are intermediate cells are there, so they have both the pointable EMA, CK7 and P63. So by the staining also in small biopsy, you can appreciate the proportion of the cells. So, squamous cell will be pointed for the P63, epithelial will be pointed for the CK7 or EMA. Adrenocystic, one of the exam slides, site, palate, lung, breast, anywhere you can see, but morphology uniform everywhere.
So, in the second form malignancy, most of the submandibular, cervical, malignant, male and female are equal, 50 grade is the common size, age, asymptomatic, enlarging mass, pain, paresthesis, facial vigorous paralysis.
This is bare circumcised again, solid, rarely with the cystic spaces and infiltrative in nature. You see this diagram, only one diagnosis, cribriform pattern, Swiss is the appearance, adrenocystic carcinoma. Tubular patterns, solid pattern, other sides. In the tubular pattern, you see layered cells forming duct-like structures.
Basically, you see some instances there. This is a solid nest of cells, there are cystic. So, whatever pattern is there, they are present private
to sir. Sir.
So, which is the malignant component?
Sir, in this case, both the things are components. Sir. Both the epithelium and epithelium. So, this is one of the other two that is dual presenting.
Why I'm asking this question is because anytime in morphology, you are mixed up with the adrenocystic predominant pneumophilic adenoma, which are the adrenocystic carcinoma. So, what is the algorithm or message to the cancer when you are caught up in a situation like this? Adenocystic is a benign tumor, is an adenocystic predominant. Which of is an adenocystic carcinoma?
Sir, adenocystic carcinoma is an infiltrative colon. Number second part, as sir asked a good question, pilomatum is a mesenchymal differentiation also. But in this case, you don't have mesenchymal differentiation, it is not there. You have seen mainly the epithelial component in mesenchymal. And pilomatum generally it is the circumscribed in nature. And in pilomatum adenoma, sir, we have seen some cases, but this is the most common vessel mucinous cysta. This is more obvious in the adrenocystic carcinoma. There we find a mixed stroma in the pilomorphic adenoma. You can see major kind of like osseous differentiation, chondral differentiation.
And in case of doubt, can I go to KA67 and see hyperproliferation patterns, which will not there in pilomorphic adenoma and which will be accessible in American?
Ha, sir. This is the other thing we can
help us.
Can help us. Sir, sir, sir. It is low in the pilomorphic.
Sir.
And one more assay we can do any mapical marker which is positive in the pilomhedroma and will not so prominent in the adrenocystic carcinoma.
The mapical marker will disappear in
Because they will be more the epithelial cells, sir. acinic cell carcinoma, second most tumor among the peritoneal penetrating malignancy. 50 degree the site, again female in the most prevalent, bilateral peritoneal disease, solitary silvering pale mass is there. And one is the characteristic feature written in the Fletcher, it is the regimen tessellate nuclei. If you remember this word in the microscopy, yours sure should be acinic cell carcinoma. So on the gross, we are seeing well demarcated lesion is there, mostly homogeneous in appearance.
So it can be, if once you see, and sometimes what is the reason? Suppose you have a small biopsy, you have a periphery or some small hospital. So you get this much of tissue. So this is normal salivary gland also. So don't make it acinic. In one case, came to RR hospital, I know to the name of the faculty. So she sent the case for review to us. So it was the normal gland, the tissue has been taken on normal side. So she or he unintentionally delivered the acinic cell carcinoma. So once we saw the complete in portfolio with the radiology, it was the normal salivary gland. So you have to see the radiology also in such case, because it might be the normal salivary gland. So solid and lactic pattern is there, most common are there, solid cell, numerous small cysts are there, polyhedral cells are there, small dark eccentric nuclei. Because in eccentric nuclei, basically placed, it is the regimentation of the cells is called. Basically, we will set up on the characteristic features.
Any other mimicers of acinic cell carcinoma? Mimicers, whether they all look same, clear like clear spaces.
Sir, there is a different DD of the clear cell carcinoma of the salivary gland. So, they are other clear cells, sir. Acinic cell generally have the, you can confuse only with the benign native salivary gland. Adenocarcinoma, generally now it is called as adenocarcinoma NOS in the data center WHO for 2007. And they have differentiated into the low grade, intermediate, and high grade, depending on satellite ATP and the mitosis. We recently reported a case in Chandni Mandir, sir. So it was adenocarcinoma NOS salivary gland. Two cases we have reported in 3 months.
So it's not so rare. We have got two cases in the last 3 months. 58 site, female or more, peritoneal gland, and malignant glands are there. Enlarging mark there because generally they are the palliative nature. 25% pain and facial weakness. Because they are rapidly growing.
One more thing I forgot to tell you about acinic cell carcinoma. They are peri-like, which are the tumors, which are the neurotropic. Prostatic adenocarcinoma is one of them. Pancreatic tumor is there. Are the acinic cell carcinoma. So they have the tendency to grow around the nerve, sir.
What about adenoid cystic carcinoma also has got a
tendency to grow on the
nerve.
Sir, sir. Exam question is there.
Both questions.
Yeah.
And this entity is a newer entity in the latest
classification? Yes, sir. WHO. Adenocarcinoma NOS. So depending on the degree grade, they are depending low grade, intermediate, and high grades. So grade we describe on the nature of the once the outline is circumcised or not there, degree of satellite ATPA, degree of mitosis, nuclear ATPA, all the features we have to take consideration. Once you see this slide, generally you come to your mind whether you are seeing any carcinoma breast or something like that actually.
So heterogeneity is there, granular structures are there, you are seeing endocarcinoma, simply endocarcinoma, absence of epithelial component, grade 1, 2 and 3. So they are depending on the satellite ATPA, mitosis, infiltrative pattern and necrosis also.
We can also see powdered necrosis in this mimicking cell. And is there any difference between this and duct carcinoma of the salivary gland?
Duct carcinoma, they are more or less the same.
Adenocarcinoma and duct carcinoma are the same.
Sir, but the origin of cells is different. Yes. Jo duct cell, they are from ductal cells and they are from acinar cells, luminal cells. Then in mixed tumor, carcinoma, epithelial adenoma, carcinosarcoma, as you will see the ovary also. Anywhere else, metastatic mixed tumors you can see from the other sides also. Carcinoma, epithelial adenoma, they are generally 2 to 4%, 4 to 6% of mixed tumors present in the 6 to 8 decades, particularly the common side, then some mandibular, then palate. Risk of malignancy is 1.5% first 5 years, then 9.5%. There are long standing pain and masses that are gross, sudden and random. So you can have the history, patient is diagnosed with primary adenoma 10 years back, 12 years back, then there are other than increased size of swelling is there, or recurrent swelling is there. So you can see the pilomorphic adenoma transfer into the carcinoma ex pilomorphic adenoma. This is the gross, they are polysarcocyte, infiltrative, hemorrhagic and necrosis. On the histology, malignant cellular changes adjacent to pilomorphic adenoma, carcinoma component.
So can you see the necrosis is there, epithelial cells is there, ATP is there, all of the islands are there. So where we are seeing, we are seeing solid nest, islands as well as the slender component with mass necrosis there, because they are the transformed into malignant component.
Carcinosarcoma, they are extremely rare. See, I have not seen any case till date. 6 decades, male and female are equal, parity of the site. History of previously excised pleomorphic adenoma or recurrent ones or recurrent treated with radiotherapy in the history we have to take the messages. Again, gross, as you are aware, polysarcocyte, infiltrative, cystic areas, hemorrhaging, necrosis, calcification. Histology, biphagic, name is obvious. Both, we have the both the malignant component. Epithelial component is malignant as well as the myopathy component is also, or mesenchymal component is malignant. So biphagy, sarcomatous component dominate, it can chondrosarcoma. If carcinomatous component dominate, it is moderate to polyneuropathy, carcinoma or endocrine. So what we are seeing here, this is the epithelial component and this is the mesenchymal component. Both the components are malignant. Other side of carcinosarcoma is the OV, you are very well aware, MMT.
Malignant means malignant tumor.
Ischemic carcinoma 1.6%. 7 to 8 decades, male to female, male are more here again. We have to look at high grade mucometic carcinoma, because what high grade means, we have more the solid component, we have more the ischemoid cells, we have more the intermediate cells, and there will be less cystic space and less epithelial cells. So this comes the DD of the ischemic cell. What the difference is, here you will find only marker quality with the P63, you will have negativity for the CK7 or EMA. And in mucometanoid, both CK7, EMA as well as P63 will be positive. Metastatic SCC, you can't differentiate, as simple as that, because we don't have any marker for that, whether it's metastatic to the salivary gland or outside. So in that case, we have to see the radiology, where is the prominent component of the tumor present, whether the lymph node mass or any lung mass is there or any oral cavity is there. So only then we can rule out the metastatic. They are encapsulated, ulcerated, or can be fixed. Histology, you are aware, infiltrative natural tumor cells, well, depending on the keratinization, degree of the keratinization, be differentiated, well differentiated, moderately and poorly, as you are very well aware. PLG. This difficult to, once we are having not finding anything, and we think PLGA generally, we after the pleomorphic adenoma comes in the DD man. So this takes time to diagnose, it takes 1 or 2 days. We have to see the slides again, as per my little experience. The second most common malignancy in the melanocytic gland, 7 decades is the age of presentation, more in the female, painless, some mucosal swelling, morphological diversity there, solid component, glandular component, cribriform, ductular, tubular, trabecular, cystic. We reported 2-3 cases sir, in last 4 months in Chandigarh there.
So what would be the algorithm now to differentiate this from a pleomorphic
adenoma? Sir, basically in this case, the epithelial component is more, number one thing, sir. And you have the history of long standing is there, sir. And mesenchymal component is very less. Difference is very less. Difference is very less. Isomorphic cells, indistinct nuclei, peripheral indefinite pattern. Whereas which is the indefinite pattern? Anyone?
Yes.
Lobular carcinoma breast.
Not us.
Kilian carcinoma, Sir Raj. This is a good table is there in Fletcher. Go and read. They have been very nicely given DD. What are the characteristic features on the growth and the microscopic other things? So they are generally glycogen rich in nature. We can see the past passive stain. Palate and the parotid common site. 6 to 8 decades the age of presentation. Male and female are equally affected. Uniform round of polygonal cells, peripheral and clear cells. Where are the other sites you find the clear cells in the other tumors? RCC, then RCC everyone knows. Endometrial, okay, then ovary, good. Because in the ovary, the importance is, sir was telling me, and the traveling from the Delhi, it becomes a state for grade 3. Clear cell carcinoma of the ovary is important to diagnose, because you label it as like endometrial carcinoma or ovarian serous carcinoma. Once you have clear cell carcinoma, it definitely becomes a grade 3 First go with the morphology only.
So metastatic RCC is a mimical. So be very careful. The second thing is, another place they get CSL cards for urinary bladder. That's the high grade.
Sir. Epithelium carcinoma. So they are less than 1%, 67 decades, female more than male. Increased risk for the second primary. History is that tumor cell has two cell types are there. Epithelial cells and macrophages and basal cells are there. Thickened basement membrane is, you can see this membrane is thickened. All the membrane is thickened. 100% carcinoma, like Sarah's lymph epithelial lesion. Parotid site, female more than male, large cells and small cells. So, in the conclusion, the salivary tumor, they are very highly diverse system morphology because the cell nature of the cells. Accurate pathogen diagnosis, different management, relatively rare malignancies are there. Utilized period, we have seen frozen section. Where we require frozen section, generally they ask you to send the lymph node involvement is there. So can they can do the radical night dissection only. So in that case, they require the HCC. This is all from my side. Any question, free to ask.
So, thank you, sir. Very enlightening and really enriching kind of insight many times. So it was a great, thank you so much.